Hello, beautiful people. How are you today? My name is Felipe Barrow. I'm here with my beautiful wife, Melida Harris Barrow. And we're coming to you live from Palm Beach. We are here at City Place. Today, just spend the day out here. We just had a great, great dinner. And now we just decided to come out here and just, you know, chit chat a little. You know how we like to do it. So we're here actually, you know, we're celebrating, as many of you know, our 10th year anniversary, and also the birthday of my wife. Actually, the date is gonna be tomorrow. Tomorrow's Sunday,
March 14th.
March 14th. But you know, we've been on this binge, which started yesterday, Friday. And you know, we had a nice little time out in Miami yesterday. Today we out in Palm Beach. Tomorrow, God sparing, we will be someplace on planet Earth. Who knows where? But we want to, you know, just come to you and just, you know, talk a little. Go ahead, babe. You, what you want to say?
Look.
See, I said, let me do the introduction because, you know, she is going to go on and on. And on.
No, I'm not.
And, you know,
and
now she can't say anything. I can't believe this.
That's not true, guys.
You know, don't. Darling.
He always says that I talk a lot, and I don't. Do I?
You had to live with her for the past 10 years. You would know that.
You know, sometimes I wake Poppy up on Sundays, and I'm at the head of the headboard preaching. And the cover is over his head. I don't care. Yeah. I keep preaching.
You know, I hear a sermon. You know those sermons that pastors, you know, the Baptist preachers give. I mean, those long. You know, when you go to church at 11 and you don't get out till 2 o'clock.
4.
4 o'clock. You know, well, see, that's just extended.
I get up at 7 and then I start talking. He's trying to stay awake. And I'm preaching till like 9 o'clock. Like, hey, babe, you know, and then he's trying to stay awake. He's like, yeah, I don't care. I just keep talking. But anyway, it's been 10 years, 10 lovely years. And let me tell you something. Marriage is beautiful. You just got to work at it. Right, babe?
Mm-hmm.
You know, a lot of times people always say, oh, they're so great. And so we are. Because what we have done is that anytime there's a dispute or anything, you know, we try to work at it. But sometimes, Poppy, oh my God, especially with this music thing and the drums, and every time he's buying something, guitar, karaoke, piano, drums, I mean, what else?
Timbales and
what you want to do, your getaway is to play the drums, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And sometimes it's so loud, I can't really function. Mm-hmm. Right, babe? So.
But you all know I'm a percussionist slash singer. I do that for her. You know, I know I put it out there.
Oh, but you don't have to do these things for me.
I
just love you the way you are without all of this frills. Trust me, Papi. I love you without all of that. Without the singing.
Yeah, but
without the drums. Without the piano, without the guitar,
But you know, all of that is me, and that's who you love, and I love
you. Babe, when I met you, were you playing piano, were you playing drums, were you playing?
But you know,
you evolved.
I always had that. I've always had that in me, you know, just a hidden discovery in the past year, you know, COVID really brought that instinct out of me. And so, you know, I just take the opportunity now to, you know, relax a little bit, you know, with my music. And, you know, that, yeah, all those songs.
But, babe, wait a minute. I didn't know you were going through therapy with your music. I need to find out, though, what's happening.
Well, you know, the therapy is just, you know, when I say therapy, you know, really what I mean is a little just, you know, creative space time, you know, where I exercise my God-given talent, you know, and that's really what it is. It's nothing to do with the relationship or anything like that. It's just my little space.
You for my best friend.
My creative juices.
You my best friend. Cool.
You are.
You my best friend, Bobby.
You are my best friend. You know, my lover. My everything.
Keep going. No, I want to hear everything. More. You got to say things. You know, I don't want everything.
You know, I had so many, you know, nicknames that I describe her. You know, mi puchonguita, mi cariño lindo, el amor bonito, mi caramelito.
Keep going, because there's more. There's more. Mi puchinguita something.
Puchinguita.
Yeah.
But you know what I enjoy really calling her, and many of you hear it all the time, is babe. Babe is something that from the beginning, both of us, you know, use that term.
Yeah.
For each other.
Poppy.
You know,
you're
so
my papi.
That connection, you know, started way back, you know, when we, you know, first got together.
Yeah.
But, you know, I got to tell you a little something. You know, although we've been married for 10 years, together 12 years, you know, we actually grew up together in 19th Street, Rio Abajo.
Panama.
And, you know, back then I was a very, very shy young man. And really never, you know, I always, you know, saw her pass by. I always looked at her. She looked at me. I looked at her, but I'm going to tell you, you know, back then, you know, she wasn't the beautiful gem that you see here today. She was a tomboy. That's how I would describe her behavior back then. And
yeah, I was,
you know,
a tomboy.
And so because of that, you know, I really,
yeah, because he knows I beat him up.
I did
you,
not
Papi, you
want
know
anything
you
to do with
me
her.
Back then. You get beat up.
Yes, absolutely. I mean, I used to see what she did to others. You know, so I didn't want no part of that. So I let it ride.
Oh,
so in 1976, she left the country. I left in 1977.
Yeah.
You know,
one month later.
One thing that I have to say, you know, even during those days back in Panama, you know, she used to wear this perfume that, oh my goodness, it was the most enticing thing that you wanna to know. And you know, she wore this perfume, and to today I have that scent.
You can still smell
engraved
it.
Engraved in my brain. You know, I could really today still smell that beautiful aroma. Where she used to pass, you know, with her school clothes. You know, she had a little blue falda and, you know, her white crisp shirt and little tie, you know, coming from Comercial, Panama, and walking into 19th Street, and me just
looking,
observing and sniffing. that aroma that she carried with her. You know, I think she was pretty probably the only woman back then, the only young girl in school that will wear perfume, because I tell you, I never smelled any other young lady with perfume but her. So even though she had that little twist of
the rough edge,
she had that.
But I had to protect myself. I think that's why I was a tomboy back then, because I think it was another way of me protecting me from the boys. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because, you know, back then she was always, you know, more mature for her age, you know. And she always used, you know, those mechanisms
to protect herself.
That's very true, Ben.
Yeah, because I didn't want boys to touch me or anything. You know how you guys used to do back in those days. So that was another way to protect me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But anyway, she left, you know, in 76. I left in 77. And, you know, years after. So it took 30 years for us to, you know, see each other again. And this is what happened, is that a bunch of us guys from back in the neighborhood were supposed to go out and just hang out and, you know, go to a little restaurant, chit chat and so forth. And it turns out that none of the people that were supposed to go, none of them
It was a setup. They set me up.
You know, I just think that, you know, because I just think they just, you know, bailed out. They had other things to do, and we weren't able to meet.
Right.
And
then
so
we met.
Just decided to just, let's go out. You know,
with no intentions of just friends.
Yeah, just go out as friends.
Yeah.
Reminisce about the good old days and everything.
Yeah.
And it happened then that, you know, we went to this club, right? We're gonna go in there and we're gonna, you know, we both love to dance. And so, you know, we're going there and we're gonna.
He asked me to dance.
And
then we went ahead and danced. And then I don't know what happened, but he always said, "What do you always say, babe?"
Well, you know, I say that actually our spirits connected on the dance floor. You know, we went out, you know, salsa, nice, you know, I like my salsa. And she does as well. And we get on the dance floor, and I just, you know, hold her hands, put my hand in the small of her back, and she could not move. She did not move. And I'm thinking, well, what happened? You know, and I just have to say that, you know, at that time, you know, my sense was that, you know, our spirits united then, because, you know, we literally had to leave the dance floor because she could not move, you know.
And I don't know what happened, but,
you know, and we went back, we sat down, and, you know, we leaned across each other, that was the birth of the first kiss.
He kissed me.
Woo!
He kissed me.
And that was just so smooth.
Yeah.
And we did that all night. You know, we didn't stop, you know, kissing each other. And everything from there is
history. So we've been married for 10 years. Honestly, I have to say thank you, Papi, for loving me. It's such a special love. You love me in spite of, and it's a beautiful love, because one of the things that I appreciate most about you is that when we first met, he always gave me flowers and things like that. But what really connected me with you, babe, was I was ill when you were in Panama. I was very sick, and he decided to ask his mom to make me soup, but I didn't know. So he called me and he said, "I have something for you that would make you feel better." and that was the soup. And I thought that that was so thoughtful because we had just met, like, I mean, we've known each other for years, but in that moment, we had just met, like, it was like, what, 4 days or 3 days, and the thought of you, you know, just doing that, you know, I said, wow, this is a nice guy, you know, so that and other little things just made me say, this is the guy for me, you know, and you've always, like, from the beginning of our relationship, you've always given me flowers until today, and you give me flowers just because, not because of a birthday or holiday or Valentine. You always come home and cheer me up and, you know, just little things like that. And you haven't changed doing that, you know, and that's important for a woman because men tend to, you know, they would start out doing things and then they stop. You continued until today.
And that is the secret of it.
Yeah.
All. You know, yes. It's to continue to do the things that you did when you first started dating.
Yes, yes.
You know, those things meant as much then as they do today.
Right.
And so you just have to maintain that.
Exactly.
You know, she goes, she travels, and she comes back home. And
every time I come back, there's roses at the airport.
You know.
And that is so nice, babe.
Yeah.
You never stop, you know.
Yeah.
And you always, like, help me with what I'm doing. You always encourage me with what I'm doing. And I think that is so important for a woman to have a husband that encourages, you know, to encourage her with her work. No matter what she's doing, you're always there to encourage me, you know, to say, keep going, babe. You know, I'm here for you. If you need anything, let me know. And I think that is love.
Absolutely.
You know,
be supportive of each other and be frank in communication, you know.
Yeah.
Very key is the communication. I know it sounds cliche, but, you know, that is a very important
communication part is important,
of the relationship.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, don't think that you know, we don't have our moments.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
where,
yeah. He gets me on my nerves sometimes.
But, you know, you...
But you still, I think, you know, when you're in a relationship, your partner, you know, will make you feel a certain kind of way. And, you know, you're going to have those issues. But I'll tell you what, if you have the love, that's the base of the relationship.
Yeah.
And the foundation of the relationship is the love. If you have love for each other, you can conquer anything. You know, so, yeah, we get mad at our partners. But the most important thing is that you have that foundation. And no matter what's crumbling on top of the foundation, you can rebuild, you know, and you can start over. And you can constantly tell each other how much you love each other. And I think that's important, you know? Mm-hmm.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So when are you getting rid of all this stuff?
It just helps also to be able to sing, you know? Gotta have some, you know, pipes, you know, that sends. That romance
for me
across, you know, you gotta be smooth that way.
Yes. This is the salsero, this is the singer, you know, in the home, you know. I'm just a workaholic. I'm working around the clock. But thank you, baby.
But yes, and you know, we just wanted to come and just, you know,
10 years.
Give you a little tidbit of, you know, our relationship and, you know, to send that positive
message
across. And I know most of you appreciate it.
Yeah.
You know, a gift from God that's been given to us, you know, this beautiful love that we share. And it's not for us to just keep it to ourselves.
Yeah.
But to demonstrate to the world, show the world.
Yeah.
the love of God. And that's the reason why we do it.
The love of God. God has blessed us. God gave us something that is truly a blessing, and that's love. You know what I mean? And I am always feeling love, you know. And we can laugh, we can get mad at each other, but that's what marriage is about, you know. Then you come right back and you start all over again, you know. It's a beautiful thing, because there's no marriage out here that's perfect. There's none. So the imperfections we have to work on, you know what I mean? So I think it's those are the things. Like when Papi said that he's gonna fix something in the house, I get scared. I get scared because babe, I'm gonna.
Go ahead, because I'll explain my basis.
He was gonna put a lamp up, and I go, oh God, I don't know about this, because the light is gonna shut down, something is gonna happen. But it wasn't his fault, but the light shut down, and we had to call an electrician.
No, that is not true.
Yes, it is.
No, remember that the panel itself was burned out. It wasn't anything to do with what I was doing. The panel was burned out.
All right.
Well, you know, many of you don't know, but I graduated from El Arte y Oficio en Electricidad. So I don't learn these things from YouTube or anything like that, you know. These things I know.
Babe,
and so
you didn't go on to YouTube. What happened
at the end of all of it?
It turned out very good. Very, I have to say, babe, thank you.
I take my bow.
But I left the house just in case there was going to be a fire. I left the house. I went shopping and I came back. And the house was still there. That was truly a blessing. I called the insurance company and I said, do we have fire insurance? but that's the fun of it.
You know, a lot of things around the house I do. I know how to do. It just takes me a little longer time to complete it. But, you know, that I can do it, I do. You know.
It takes him five years to put a lamp up. 5 years, 10 years to do this, and 6 years to do that. That's a simple thing.
Yeah, it just takes me a little time, but eventually it gets there. And when it gets there, it's full perfection. So,
babe, that's it. You know how to defend yourself, though.
That's it.
And I love that about you. You know how to defend yourself. But anyway.
Yeah. But anyway, guys, you know, we just wanted to, you know, share a little bit of us with you. And I hope that this has been an inspiration to you.
Yeah. And we are enjoying ourselves. Tomorrow is our anniversary, March 14th. And I can't wait for
it's
tomorrow.
It's also my wife's birthday.
And my birthday.
And so.
March 14th. Awesome. So, I love you, baby.
I love you too, baby.
Keep your marriage going, no matter what.
Love each other always.
All right,
guys.
We love you guys.
Okay, you take care.
I love you, baby.
Love you too, mama.